Destroy Yoda, you will. Easy, it will be. Strong with the Force is Kazanjian M. Guide you he will, but you must listen. There are 17 steps you must take before going to the dark side. Shade you will on the dark side. Now hit the like button. Ha ha ha. That was an old Jedi mind trick. Begin now, you must. But grab paper and pencil first.
Hey, thanks a lot, Yoda.
Welcome, you are.
Step 1. Make this trapezoid shape. Step 2. Make another trapezoid. Step 3. Add the egg shape and the circle shape. Step 4. Carefully place the eye shape in the middle of the two shapes from the previous step. Step 5. Add eyebrows, nostrils, and tone to the eyes. Step 6. Add the wrinkles to the mouth that you see. Step 7. Give Yoda a double chin. Step 8. Add the line on the side of Yoda's face. Step 9. Add the triangular ear shape. Notice its relationship with the eye shape. Step 10. Add Yoda's first forehead. Step 11. Add Yoda's second and third forehead. Step 12. Add the other ear and notice the banana shape that is formed, including the two ears and the eye shapes in between. Step 13. Close the head shape. Step 14. Add the neck shape. Step 15. Add the first shape for the clothing. Step 16. Add the hood. Step 17. Add the folds to the shirt. Hey everyone, welcome to the dark side of the Force, the shading segment. And I've got good news for you. If you've made it this far, this part will be pretty easy for you. And I recommend that you watch it maybe one or two times. And you'll get the hang of it. I'm doing a method called cross-hatching, and you're going to see me zoom in and zoom out. But I'm just basically putting delicate lines where I see darkness from the reference image. And you'll see that the area by the ear is the darkest part, and also the eye on the far left, which of course would be his right eye, the edge of that gets really dark as it curves in towards the ear. Yoda is not human. I hate to break it to you Star Wars fans, but he kind of has a different anatomy to him. Well, Yoda's not real, I know that, but... the proportions, of course, of the ears to the head, it's not real, so it'll give you a little bit of creative license to work on this likeness. If you have, the form of your drawing down, that's all you really need for this, and you can actually be creative with the shading. There's a really delicate shadow that's going on the left-hand side of the face, his right side. And you're going to see me cross and hatch quite a bit. The shadow is more complex than the highlight area. The highlight area, you really have to be precise with your lines. Be very precise, as close as possible with your lines. The shadow area, there are layers and layers of depth in there. And I really want you to observe the reference image as well as watch what I'm doing. I am doing, for the lighter sections, I don't just leave everything light. I do some hatching over the lighter areas, and then I erase, and that will serve as my highlight. The hatching that I do is almost as light as the paper, but when I erase, the lightest value, of course, that we can work with is totally blank paper. So when I use my kneaded eraser or the eraser at the end of my pencil, it just picks it up and... there's that slight differentiation in tone between, the blank paper and the area that I erased. Notice that the sides of the mouth slightly curve downwards, and there are lines that kind of go down at the end, and they're not as dark as the area that's in between the lips, but they are present. As for the clothing, he's wearing a hoodie. So I kind of followed the same format. It's going to be dark towards the left, and it's going to be in highlight over on the right. And remember, the highlights are, you want to do a little bit of shading and then erase. That's what I recommend. The hair is very sparse. You want to establish the tones first underneath it, and then do individual strands for the hair. And you don't want to put them all in the same direction. You want them to slightly alter the direction for each one of those, because hair does not all go in the same direction. The ear, notice the strong highlight that exists on the ear and on the forehead, and on the corner of the mouth. Please note I left the whites of the eyes pretty white. There's only a little bit of shading that's going on in there. In a moment or two, you're going to see me use both the paintbrush and the blending stump, and I'm doing that just to mimic the values that we see in the reference image. Actually, the reference image is my drawing, but you're going to see me use here the paintbrush to kind of like smudge the tones, create that neutral tone, and then I could carve out of it with the eraser. I could carve those highlights out. The blending stump kind of allows you to elongate lines without using the pencil so that there's a change in tone. So for instance, tone in pencil, there's only a little bit of control that you can get with that. Or I shouldn't say that. It's very hard to have that control with that. Using a blending stump with it, which is just paper, it's rolled up paper, I could kind of extend those lines. I can pull those lines, and it creates that smudge effect. And then I erase, and that's how I get those big changes in tone. I know that the ear is blocked right now. You're going to see the finished picture without any blockage whatsoever. So excuse that for the moment. Now we're putting on the finishing touches, and you're seeing me really look at the image. You don't see me take a step back, but I do. I make sure that the lines on the edges are true to what we see in the reference image. For instance, underneath the ear, you might notice that it's not a solid line. I'm just trying to do that. And if you guys do one of these, please either post it on my Facebook page. I'll put the link in the video description. Or you can do a video response to this video. I love seeing your work. And it inspires me to make more of these tutorials. So by all means, send it to me one way or the other, either through a video response or the Facebook page. And I almost always get back to people. I love seeing those. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. And yeah, I hope that this video helped you. If you could please hit the like button if it did. And there is the finished image. Thank you so much for joining us today.